Hey everybody, Bar Mattson here at Motorcycle USA. This is the V-Strom 650. Suzuki has invited us out to the press launch for a pretty significant redesign for the 2012 model. We're in the Blue Ridge Mountains and we're riding it around on street and dirt to see how it acts. So come on, let's go for a ride.
The V-Strom got a significant facelift with new bodywork, including liberal use of black resin throughout the design. The front is slimmer, and both the front and rear have been pushed in for a more compact look. There's a new windscreen, and designers also cleaned up the messy oil cooler on the previous model. All told, the 2012 model is a dramatic improvement, at least when it comes to styling. Get behind the controls, and the 32.9-inch seat still delivers a pretty easy reach to the ground with its slim contours. High and low seat options are available, which raise or lower seat height 20 millimeters, and we prefer the high seat option. A new instrument console delivers all the essential information in our favorite format with a left side analog tach and a right side digital speedo. The LCD display also houses a digital engine temperature gauge and fuel gauge, as well as two trip meters, a clock, and ambient air temperature. Suzuki changed up the V-Strom engine too. Instead of using the SV650 twin, this new model sources the V-twin powering the Gladius. The 645cc V-twin maintains the same bore and stroke, but features new pistons, cylinders, and cams. This gives the new V-Strom a little more torque down low and some extra oomph up top. On the road, engine performance isn't overpowering. The V-Strom feels quite mellow off the bottom, with more meat coming on between 4,000 to 6,000 RPM. As the revs rise, some vibes come up through the tank, but that's when the 650 spools up for more spirited riding. Thankfully, this year's V-Strom can better handle a faster pace, as it features a firmer suspension package with the rear shock spring rate increased and the front fork stiffened up. The new settings keep more weight on the front end and transmits good feel from the road. The V-Strom is a neutral handler and quite reactive to rider input. Braking performance, like engine performance, isn't overwhelming or spectacular, but gets the job done. Overall, the bike is surprisingly competent when the road starts to bend, where riders will appreciate the relatively low peg feelers keeping the wide bags off the asphalt. And we also took the V-Strom out on the dirt. While the precariously placed engine components, particularly the exposed oil filter, keep gnarly dirt excursions ill-advised, the V-Strom proved a playful companion on the novice-level dirt roads we sampled branching off the Blue Ridge Parkway. The Bridgestone trail wing tires perform better on loose surfaces than our confidence gave them credit for. The new Bosch ABS system unfortunately cannot be turned off. The standard V-Strom 650 ABS is available in metallic fox orange for $8,299. US market will also get the 650 Adventure for $97.99, which includes the touring windscreen, protective crash guards, and aluminum side cases. After 2 days touring the Blue Ridge Mountains, we found the Suzuki V-Strom to be an eminently practical mount. With its willing engine, more adept suspension, and updated look, the V-Strom 650 is a pleasing little do-it-all middleweight.